Hi,
welcome to the Pier 54 podcast.
I'm Amanda Kimmel.
And I'm Shannon Coach, and we are your hosts.
Hi, and welcome to the recap of the April 8th through April 12th episodes of General Hospital. We are here to just do a quick recap. I don't know about you, Amanda, but I just kind of feel like there wasn't a whole lot to talk about this week.
So boring.
I know that last week we said that we were going to pick our top three, you know, favorite, not favorite. Do you even have three?
No.
Okay. So why don't you, what do you have, like one favorite part? Do you want to start with the bad or the good?
My bad is good. I like on Thursday when they were focusing around Oscar and
they remembered Oscar.
They took him long enough to get back to him.
Took a whole week, you know.
But I thought that was very well played. I thought it was realistic. I thought that they got into enough depth without taking it like too morbid.
Yeah.
And everything felt very authentic. And I like the fact that they mentioned Jax because that makes me think,
dun, dun, dun.
Is he going to come back for Jocelyn being devastated by Oscar's death?
I don't know. Will he?
I'm hoping.
One can only hope that Mr. Ingo Rademacher.
That would be an appropriate response. He needs to be there for her.
I think so. Jax is a good dad, and he would be there for that.
Yes, and I liked that Carly was talking about the book and how she hadn't read it, and that Jax is who gave it to her, and that Jax was going to love
there's,
it.
There's
and
a lot like, of Jax dropping in there.
Yes, so that made me happy, and like I said, just the fact that it felt very authentic. They were planning, they were trying to stay as positive as possible, but they were still being realistic, and everyone was sad, but it didn't like totally drag you down.
Right.
And just the fact that we got back to him, because like you said, it took us almost an entire week before we got there.
Because I do like that Oscar is not bouncing back. As wrong as that is, you know, it's right. No, he's taken the next step. You know, he was okay. What they say, the stroke was worse.
Yes. The seizure was worse.
The seizure was worse. Sorry.
That's okay. The seizure was worse. He was in the coma. He's going to keep having more seizures.
Right. He's not going to get better. He's not going to go do his stuff. That's sad, though.
It is sad, but I'm glad, like we had talked about before, we don't want to see him die, but that's not exactly there's not a magic cure for a brain tumor. So the fact that they're keeping it along the lines of how real life would go makes me happy. So again, it was bad because I don't want Oscar to die, but it was good because I liked the way that they were portraying it realistically.
Right.
Besides that, I liked seeing Willow and Chase finally hook up because they had kind of been like, back and forth. So
he's a respectful guy and understands that she's needed some time.
Yes, and they were definitely like with the whole consent thing. Like he stopped and was like, "Are you sure that you want to do this?"
Right, blah, blah, blah. Right.
So I felt again that they kept him in character without just having them like rip their clothes off in a moment of passion,
right,
and then being like, "Oh wait,
was that okay?"
Exactly. So I like the fact that he did it appropriately, but there was still a lot of like passion, and you could tell that like she was totally into it. How could you not be into it?
they are cute though. I do.
They
like
are
them.
Like I like that they're just like a sweet normal couple. Like
they are what we could have aspired Joss and Oscar to become.
You know,
not everything has to be. Do you know what I like the most about Chase is that he is. Willow's got some drama. I mean, you know, he's very considerate of her feelings, her past. He doesn't try to fix her.
He's willing to listen and just let her kind of take her time with everything and lead the way, which is nice to see.
He offers opinions and he offers help. And you're right. Like he leads, you know, he's like, all right. Well, I mean, it kind of helps that he's a detective and is like, hey, this is what we can actually do. Just so you know, wink, wink. What did he tell Michael? He's like, even if I was willing, I couldn't break the law.
I like that Michael was smart enough to be like, my dad can handle this. He's very powerful. And then he was like, he is a legend.
Mom, boss,
blah, blah, blah.
Right.
That was really funny.
It's like, oh, wait, I got to shut up now.
Even in the presence. Like, even in Chase's own house, he was like, oh, I'm still going to make sure I use the word.
How awkward was that, though, when he walked in on that? I think Michael's over his little crush on her. You know, I think that Michael's reasonable enough that he gets it. And it's not like he and Chase actually fought for her.
Right.
So,
but they do need to bring in a good girl for him.
They do.
I don't know that I see him with Sasha. Like, there's good chemistry there.
Yeah, but as soon as it's discovered that she's not Nina's daughter, she's going
to
be gone.
Exactly. And why does he have to keep falling in love with these people that are, like, nasty and then have to go away?
I don't know.
He deserves a good relationship.
He does.
So I hope they work on that. Maybe that will be, like, the summer drama. They usually have good relationships during the summer to, like, hook all the teen viewers. Maybe that will be.
Because, like, he was really good with Star, and then One Life to Live had to go and sue General Hospital for the rights to their characters back, even though they ended their show.
You're a little bitter there.
I get that they started to revive the show on, I mean, because do you know that they actually sued because General Hospital killed Cole?
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Okay.
I believe that, like, there was some big legal thing there because they're like, you killed our character. And they're like, you ended your show.
Right.
We took your characters.
Right. And they're like, yeah,
but
we want to.
But they revived it online on the Soap Network.
Okay.
So they wanted to be able to bring back their characters. Meanwhile, they all stayed on General Hospital. So.
Yes.
You know.
Yeah, they could have found a better way to do that. But,
yeah.
Whatever.
Not better. Just like. it's business. It's, yeah.
I liked that Nora was talking more about, like, the One Life to Live world. Like, she brought up her son.
What was that?
And so that makes me wonder also, like, are they going to have more characters? Are we starting up again somewhere else? I would be so happy if they came back.
But here's the thing. So we have Nora.
Mm-hmm.
Why do we get her? But we couldn't keep John McBain and Todd, because I'm sorry, I did like Carly and Todd.
Yes.
They were really good together.
Yeah.
You know, and I really liked John McBain and Sam.
Yeah.
They were really good together.
Right.
And I liked Star and Michael.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. But they can't do that. We cannot have Michael Easton change his character
again. No?
He cannot go back to being John McBain. Say Finn. Stay with Finn. What did you think about that this week?
Mm-hmm. Finn just still doesn't excite me. I don't know.
I love him.
I like him. I don't know.
I just think he's cute.
I like how he's not perfect. Like,
yes.
Because so many other men are, like, perfect. There's not men like that in the real world. So I like the fact that he is flawed and he seems nervous and he is just goofy and whatever, like, mm-hmm. practicing the proposals to the skeleton kind of things. But
right.
I don't know. I feel like they're taking it too far, like, too long. Like, just propose already. Like, come up with something and do it.
Yeah.
It's dragged out a whole week now. That was last Friday that they were in the floating rib.
Well, and he got a little bit smart with Robert this week.
Mm-hmm.
But then Robert shut him down.
Yeah.
He was like, what the heck are you thinking? No. He's like, I'm just telling you, this is how she gets. You know,
yeah.
So I stand by my thought last week of, I don't think that Robert's really trying to move in on her.
No.
I think that he is legit just trying to
be a good friend. Right.
Right. And he sees Finn trying.
Mm-hmm.
And so he's trying to help him, you know, but.
Yes.
I mean, really laid into him.
He did. I don't like the whole Anna storyline of questioning if she's Robin's mother, though. That just
Why
feels
is she
dumb.
Not questioning if she's Peter's? I mean, that is the very obvious one that is right there. Why am I not questioning these memories I barely can remember, but I'm going to question the one that I remember the most?
Right. And that you have people to back you up. Like, I know Robert wasn't there through all of it, but he was like, no, I know what I'm talking about. And again, he was supposed to be a spy. You really think he can't tell the difference between...
She did bring up a good point, though, that when they got together,
he didn't know her
the way that he does now. However,
I think
by now he would have been like, you know, you were a little different when we first got together.
Exactly. Yeah.
You know,
I understand he didn't know her then, but he knows her now, and that's enough to reflect on the past.
Right.
If he's sure that it was her, then it's her.
Mm-hmm. No, absolutely. So was that the only thing that you had?
Oh, my only other note was Sam was dumb.
And why was Sam dumb?
On Monday, whenever she went into Donna Day and was exploring the attic, I felt like the fact that she didn't get caught was crazy. She was way too
I remember that.
She went in to see, they had set up the attic for Christina's ceremony.
Oh, that's right. And she went in and she hid behind the curtain or whatever.
Yeah.
And I thought she was going to, here's what a PI should have done, recorded. What they were saying, maybe?
Exactly.
That's why I thought she took out her phone.
No.
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 You're right.
No. And just the way that she, like, walked in the house and walked up there and was, like, moving stuff around.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know. I felt like Jason was kind of sloppy, too, but I'm assuming he moved a little faster to get Christina out.
I think that his was more of a, you go in, it doesn't matter.
And
you know,
isn't
and you
trying,
get her.
Exactly. He wasn't trying to pretend like he belonged there.
He
like
shot if, anyone that got in his way. I'm
yeah,
like, come on.
If he got caught,
allegedly
he'd have
shot
been
anyone.
Like, yes, I'm taking her because I'm taking her. But if Sam got caught, it would have blown her whole cover. So
right.
She should have been a little more sneaky.
Although, how funny was Molly yelling at her at the end of the week? And then the little smile that Sam gave, like, after she walked away, she's like, I saw it, like, as a proud big sister. You know, like, oh, I'm so proud of her. You know, she's not going to let anything happen to us.
I like Molly. I hope they develop that character more. I like her.
I go back and forth on Molly because I think that she does get overly self-righteous sometimes.
Yeah, but she's young, and that's, like, the right age for
But she...
And, I mean, she is the most sane person out of her whole family. Her mother's a whack job. Her sisters are a whack job. How funny. I'd be a little self-righteous, too.
Therapist name's Neil. We didn't remember his name. Yes. It's Neil. But how funny was she when she, like, goes to visit him, and he's like, I'm sorry, I don't have time. She's like, my daughter's in a cult. And he's like, okay. Like, we'll just do this.
Sit down. I guess we're going to have therapy at the floating room.
How? This is where I'm so confused, because... Now he's like some world-renowned cult therapist.
Right. But we didn't know that 2 weeks
No.
ago.
When Alexis first booked. So here's the thing. Alexis first booked her appointment with him beforehand. I mean, I do therapy. When you go to find a therapist, you see what they specialize in.
Right.
Some don't specialize in adolescents. Some won't do children. Some will do religious aspects. You know, pretty sure that
cult
might have been listed. So she picked her therapist blindly, apparently, or maybe it was recommended, but still, you do a little research. You're a lawyer.
Right.
Do some research before just
just open the acting. Phone book.
But I did think that was funny. And then Sunny like talked him into it and everything. But it occurred to me, I think I know why we're doing the Dawn of Day thing. Do you know what the Nexium thing is?
Mm-mm.
The Nexium cult? They're a cult in New York.
Oh.
And when, who said it this week? They were like, I think it was Sam said that they have some really high profile members.
Oh, okay.
One, there's an actress from some show that I don't watch, but she apparently joined this cult, but now she's being charged because they wound up being a sex ring.
Oh, wow.
There's a 2020 on it. There's a whole bunch of stuff on it. So, hey, 2020 is also on ABC. Yeah, so, I mean, it's really, it's a kind of crazy, I mean, it's a cult.
Yeah.
And they've attracted some big names and everything. And so I was like, oh, I wonder if that's where they kind of got the idea, because that's happening in that area of New York.
Right.
They should probably mirror it, because, I mean, they even do that sometimes with the weather, like with the big snowstorms and everything. They'll have a major snowstorm on General Hospital. So they pay attention to those tiny details. But they don't pay attention to the fact that Alexis did not raise her three daughters. I feel like we are just going to constantly go back to that as a bar to be held against.
But Anna said that too this week when she was talking about Robin. She was like, I raised this girl. And
I was like, no, you did not.
It didn't.
Does everyone forget that Mac raised all these kids?
Exactly. And she had said, like, in one of the previous episodes about how she didn't get to raise Robin because she couldn't let on that it was her kid because it was born. She was born in this crazy circumstance.
Right.
And so she went back and visited her, that Robin called her Lovey or whatever for the longest time.
Yeah. Don't know.
But yet you raised her.
What if Robin's actually a twin? That because remember, she got kidnapped.
Yes.
And what if they accidentally gave her back non-Robin?
There you go.
And now real Robin's out somewhere.
Maybe it was fake Robin that came back and interrupted Patrick's wedding to Sabrina.
Dun, dun, dun. Oh, but Sabrina is dead.
I'm sorry.
So we can't even revive that.
Maybe she has a twin, too.
No, I really liked Sabrina and Patrick.
I like Sabrina, too.
I still think that she should have gotten Patrick. Robin, I know she's the favorite, but she left a lot.
She did.
And she continues to, but now she's leaving with her family, so that's good.
Right.
But I just don't understand how Christina doesn't think she's in a cult. Like,
I mean, I guess if you're in it, you don't see it, but...
Yeah, but...
I don't have money. I don't know how you get all that money. I wish my siblings would hand me $10,000.
Well, he is a quarter man, so there's that. So we're just going to join, like, mine and yours, because you're hitting on a lot of my favorite ones, too.
Okay.
One of the things that I thought was... Were you done?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. Because we're just talking about the cult, Dawn of Day. I think the Harmony is Willa's mom.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. But that feels weird to me because they made it seem at first like Harmony and
Shiloh
were together. And then it was like.
But what if. No, because that'd be gross. I was thinking, you know how like a lot of these, in a lot of the cults, the kids are born into it and raised into it. And then they do wind up.
Right.
Being the chosen one for the leader. But Shiloh's too young for that.
Yes.
So, I don't know. Wonder how Shiloh decided. Like, how do you just decide to start a cult?
I don't know.
Like, how does that happen? I can't even get my kids to, like, pick their clothes up off the floor. Like, these cult leaders are really, they could be doing good
yes.
in the world.
Write some parenting books.
No, not as they are now. Not as they are now. We don't need their parenting books. But I mean, if they really channeled that into something good.
Yes. Yes. You know, get people to follow for the right reasons.
Right. I know where you're going. Like, hey, it's a good idea to clean your room. Hey, here's how you make food.
Yes.
You know, my kids do know how to cook and like clean and stuff, but.
It's kind of like all that YouTube crap where people are like, why can't someone create a YouTube challenge to clean your room instead of.
Because that's not deadly. I don't know. So finally, Peter and Maxie.
Yes.
Oh!
They're so cute. And I liked that he like stopped them. Like, I know that the baby woke up and so that like stopped it.
Yeah.
But she was like, let's do this.
Yeah. And he was like, nope, you are not ready. And I was like, oh, you're so good.
Yes.
So respectable.
Yes.
However, who was watching James? Because they got home.
Mm-hmm.
And he asked her out for the next night. And she's like, yeah, I should be able to get a sitter. But they go in and there's no sitter.
Right.
And she has to go take care of James.
Right.
Was James just hanging out by himself?
Yeah. She has one of those fancy phone app monitors.
That is not a babysitter. That is not a babysitter.
Yeah, I don't know. They're usually very good about showing them relieving the babies.
Right. Like, why weren't Mac and Felicia watching them? Watching him.
Right.
Hey. Oh, we'll leave you alone. Yeah. You know, like, why?
Anyone.
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 Why wasn't Lulu?
Never met anyone.
Oh, and
Lulu's
then
not in town.
I know, I forgot. Lulu's leaving. Hold it. But that was my other, seriously, moment.
Oh.
A book. And I wrote, star, I roll. Maybe Laura should write one first. You think? She's kind of been through a little bit more.
I liked Peter pointing out the fact that, or not Peter, Valentine pointing out that since it wasn't in the custody
agreement, I know!
That she doesn't just get to pick
so up. So Amanda and I both have custody agreements with exes. You know, I mean, we're accommodating
it's fun to point out when things are not in the custody agreement, so.
And it's like, you don't get to say that I'm unreasonable because, you know, you want to do something and it's completely off.
Right. It's Lulu is not a good parent.
It's not she like Laura typically watches her with Lulu.
Yes.
Or she's used to Sunday dinners at Laura's house because that's when Lulu has her. Fine then. We will continue to send Charlotte over for Sunday dinners.
Mm-hmm.
Totally fine. But you can't just... Because I did defend the Laura helping Lulu. Because she is taking care of her child.
I understand that. But you still have to make your child follow... The rules.
And they have to make sure that Valentine's on board. Because if my ex and I don't agree, it's whatever's in writing, you know? And we're both can try to be considerate enough of each other. I mean, stuff happens last minute all the time, but stuff like this doesn't.
Right. You have to do best interest of the kids. Mm-hmm. So I hope that he does end up letting her have some visitation. Or like he said.
Well, he said, if Charlotte wants to see you, she will see you.
But you don't just get to decide for me. Because you're the grandparent.
Right. But him threatening Spencer. I mean, come on.
Could he be
more childish?
Exactly.
It's like, Valentine, you've got me pulling for you until you threaten a child.
Right. Right. And like, that's such old news now. If we're going to punish him for messing with the election, punish him. Mm-hmm. And if we're not, then just let it go. Okay.
Right.
He's like, what, 14? Like, come on.
I don't even know anymore. Although I do think Aiden mm-hmm. is appropriately aged because he was born in 1990. And so he'd be 9. No, wait. 2010, so he'd be 9. Yeah. Anybody else still think that, like, you know, 10 years ago was the 90s? I think that that was really, for some reason, I wrote down that I was really glad that Margot and Sunny never happened. Because remember how for a little while there we were, and I forget why I said that, though.
Because she said, no, they weren't going to keep looking for Ryan.
Ryan.
I bet that made you mad.
Yeah. Why were the charges dropped? And how did he not at least get charged with fraud? Because it's still fraud that he presented a person as another person.
Right.
Sure. I understand Nora saying that Ryan's dead, so technically couldn't have any charges against him.
Yes.
But I don't think that would be true.
No.
I feel like if you came back from the dead, whatever charges had been outstanding against you would probably... Oh, because you didn't die.
Right.
So therefore, the charges are still standing.
Yep.
Even if in the eyes of the law...
Right. There has to be some other...
That means the law was recourse. A mistake. You know, it's like we're now rightfully releasing prisoners who are proven innocent through DNA, even though, quote unquote, all the evidence
mm-hmm.
convicted them. 30 years later, we're letting them free. They should have been free the whole time.
Right.
But the law can be wrong.
Yes.
You know, so incorrectly, and it happens. Right. You know, I mean, there's plenty of people that have been, you know, labeled as presumably dead that later find out they're not.
Right.
You know, does that mean that they have no rights to...
some type of charges, or like Nora had said when she was talking to him, this is either going to end up with like mandatory therapy time or like community service or something, or you're going to go to jail. I'm trying to keep you out of jail.
Right.
He should have got some type of sentence. I understand if they wanted to excuse it because of the technicality, but
yeah,
he still did something wrong.
He did. He really did. And the thing is, like, the whole time he's sitting there listening to Margot and Nora go back and forth, I was really expecting him to stand up, have a little bit of integrity, to maybe start working towards getting some kind of a good reputation back and say, you know what, seriously, can I just be found guilty? Or, you know, I will plead to maybe a lesser charge, you know, revoke my license, suspend my license, you know, for him to just get off scot-free. Granted, Laura gets her money back, so yay.
Yeah, I didn't like it.
No,
it was really the way it went. And the fact that his next stop was General Hospital to get his license back, like,
you know,
have other things going on that you're a little more excited.
Yeah.
Mm-mm.
No. Did we just both do that?
At the same time.
It's just, yeah, that was just crazy. But yeah, I think that's really, the one thing that I did like is when Ava, Felicia, and Laura all sat down together.
Mm-hmm.
I liked that because I think this is going to do what Ava was hoping Griffin would do.
Right.
That, because she does. She has that want for goodness in her life, and she just feels like she doesn't deserve it, feels like she can't do it. Granted, her perhaps seeking revenge on Ryan is not going to end in a good act.
If she's hoping not to seek revenge, like to hurt him, but to seek revenge for him to have a proper punishment, then that would be good.
If she kills him herself, that's...
right, then that will be wrong. But hopefully...
But that's vigilante justice, though. Yeah. So, I don't know.
I mean, he killed her daughter, so I would probably kill him also. But I am hoping that through the relationship with Felicia, that she can...
I did like when Laura's like, or when, because Ava said it to her. I think it was Ava said it to Laura. She was like, you might want to leave so that you're not. Right. I was like, aw, you're looking out for her. Like, you could be considerate criminal, you know, but I do. I think that whatever happens through this whole Ryan thing is going to, I think it's going to bring Ava that peace that she was looking for when she was trying to find that through her relationship with Griffin, you know, that she can turn over a new leaf. And maybe, I mean, if she's teaming with Laura and Felicia, maybe she'll be able to get a little bit of credibility in changing her reputation in the community too, you know, because if they're working with her, they could be like, listen, Ava led this charge, you know, got our help. I'm interested to see who the heck they're going to have her have a relationship with so that Ryan comes out of hiding.
I was wondering if they were going to have Kevin pursue her, if he would do that. Like, if that would be...
You don't think
his...
that would be, like, really weird?
It would be really weird, but it would make sense because there would have to be jealousy between the brothers, like, obviously.
Yeah.
And that could be Kevin's way of paying back what he did wrong.
Because
Laura's not ready to be with him right now anyway. Mm-mm. Not saying that they actually have to develop a relationship, but I mean,
but
it wouldn't
just,
be counterproductive. Like, it wouldn't be like Sam and Jason. I don't understand how they're not caught yet because they're over here in this corner kissing.
Why
and
is
then
she having
she's
these
like,
conversations right outside in the middle of public in the wide open space?
Exactly.
She should go to Pier 54 and have that conversation. By the way, we do know that there's a lot of stuff out there that says Pier 52 is because we actually got the Lucy Coe's book to Guide to Port Charles, and there's a section in there that says Pier 52. However, if you do like a really intensive research online, Pier 54 is the newer one that's been talked about a lot. And Pier 54 just kind of sounds better. It rolls off the tongue a little bit easier, I think, than Pier 52. So that's a quick squirrel moment for us. But she should. I mean, they should. She needs to be in her home having those conversations.
Yes.
You know, not outside of Kelly's or the Floating Rib or anywhere. Yeah.
Right. So Laura and Kevin wouldn't have that same issue because they're not together right now. So Kevin could step in and pursue Ava, and that would make Ryan jealous, I would think. And he would come back to...
Because
he had no problem killing Kevin. It's not like they have a good relationship.
Very true.
So he would come back to kill Kevin and claim his woman, and then they can arrest him and put him away for good.
Yeah, that does make sense.
But I don't know. They didn't say. They didn't say who they would pick. But that's just the
logical choice.
Because
there really is no one for her to get with. You know, like she can't go with Franco. She can't go with Scotty. Oh, maybe she could go with Scotty.
But I don't know. I don't see that. No. Kevin to me was the obvious choice. But we'll see.
Yeah. But Scotty also has a little bit, well, I guess Kevin has a little bit more of a public image right now because of this whole case and everything that he would maybe be getting some kind of coverage. But just thinking Scotty might get just because he's always all over the news and everything. So I don't know. I guess we shall see.
We shall.
But yeah. So, I mean, I was kind of with you. I mean, Friday even kind of ended on a, wait, is that, has it already been time? You
right.
Know?
Yes.
So, I mean, I have nothing else.
Yeah, you know. Friday ended dumb. I was glad that Ava chose not to drink.
Yes!
That was good. She had
really
a coffee
proud of
instead.
Her, yeah.
But yeah, they did that weird, like, pan the window, and then it was like, oh, is that Ryan or not? And then it was just done.
Yeah.
And I was like, really? It's over?
Right.
Yeah, this week, I hope it means they're gearing up for, like,
it's like a bridge
really
week.
Good for Easter week.
Yeah.
Or something, because...
Oh, there probably won't...
There won't be one Friday.
Friday, probably. Well, you knew exactly what I was thinking. Mm-hmm. So next week's episode will only, or next week's recap will only cover probably Monday through Thursday then. We have our episode on Thursday. I think we decided that we're going to talk about the Hardys,
yes.
The Hardy family.
Hardy family.
We talked about the Baldwin family last Thursday. We did a nice little trip down the family tree, hot mess that it is and everything. And there was a section that I did say something. And as I was listening to the edited version, you know, what we released, and I want to clarify one thing that I said, because I said something about Scotty's real dad. And I actually kind of hate that I said it, because adoption and fostering is so important to me. And I mean, I wouldn't have so much of my family if it wasn't for adoption. Like I don't, and I mean, my husband is even legally my kid's stepdad, but like, we don't refer to him as a stepdad. You know, it's, I don't think that blood makes you real or unreal, you know, marriage doesn't do that, you know, so I just want to apologize for the fact that I did say real dad. If no one else picked up on that, you know, it still bothered me enough that I wanted to clarify that, because that bothered me that I said that after I kept listening to it. I'm like, but it doesn't matter if they're blood or not. It just, yeah. So Lee and Gail were Scotty's real parents, even though,
right.
Oh, I remember I said he's not even really a Baldwin. He's not genetically a Baldwin.
Right.
He's a Baldwin, though.
Yeah.
He was raised as a Baldwin. And then also, I had said about how I couldn't remember how I remembered Catherine, but not Dominique.
Mm-hmm.
It turns out that Dominique died in May,
which
would have been like during the
this.
School
yep.
year for me. However, Catherine joined over the summer, which means I would have been watching every day
right.
over the summer. So that's how I knew Catherine, but not Dominique, because summer break.
Right.
I watched General Hospital.
Mm-hmm. What else do you do with your summer?
I know. I was a teenager, so maybe we shouldn't get on our kids about being on YouTube over the summer, because every day I was like, it's 2:55.
Yes.
Couch.
But they don't watch anything as good as General Hospital.
No, they don't. My daughter did ask me. She came down when I was watching and she goes, is it another new episode? And I said, yeah. She's like, how many are there? I'm like, over 14,000. And the look on her face, I said, well, it's been on for 56 years.
She's like, I can't binge that on.
I was like, do you want to start watching with me? She's like, nope.
My kids watch it enough that they can comment. They're like,
yeah.
What's that sunny guy doing now? Or isn't that so-and-so's daughter or whatever? So they're getting into it, but they're not hardcore fans yet, which makes me sad. I hope they get into it.
JD's well enough first. He knows exactly who Sunny is.
Good.
He does know that Michael Easton has been a billion characters, because he will still ask, is he still the doctor today? Or is he back to being the vampire? Or is he back to being the cop? So
there you go.
Yes. So, well, I guess that is that for our weekly recap. Anything else you want to talk about?
No. Hopefully next week will be more exciting.
I hope so too. Or this week. Next week. Whatever it is.
Whatever. The upcoming episodes.
The upcoming episodes will hopefully be a little bit more exciting for us, and
hopefully this was just the groundwork for some big
big
reveal next week.
Yes, that would be fantastic. And well, so yes, so join us on Thursday's episode, and we will be talking about the Hardy line, which does include a little bit of Weber.
Mm-hmm.
Because
there was just no way not to.
There was no way to not talk about a little bit of Weber's, but we're not going to go full Weber trip.
Right.
We'll so we're just going to do the Weber branch that comes from the Hardy line. So until next time,
have a good week.
And we'll meet you at the pier. Goodbye.
Bye.